The May 15th tornado outbreak proved that Connecticut can occasionally get significant severe weather. On Monday, May 14th, all models were agreeing that southern New England would encounter a dangerous severe weather outbreak. But Tuesday morning, the Storm Prediction Center had most of Connecticut in an enhanced risk of severe weather, and it's rare on its own to have most of Connecticut under an enhanced risk. The tornado outlook was also more impressive than normal, with a 5% tornado area. This hasn't been seen many times. We don't usually get the 5%. We usually just get the standard low end 2%. There's also a 30% chance of significant winds outlined in the hatched area. That's very significant. And there was also a 15% chance of some severe hail. By 1:30 on Tuesday, the Storm Prediction Center upgraded to a moderate risk of severe weather for parts of northwestern Connecticut. This is extremely rare. We don't usually get these, and they also, Storm Prediction Center also increased the wind threat to a 60% chance, level 5 out of 5. By 2 p.m. on the afternoon of the 15th, the tornado watch was issued for all of northern Connecticut, and by 2:45 p.m. there was a dangerous significant storm that was about to enter Connecticut, and by 2:58 a tornado warning was issued for far northwestern Connecticut. This storm was extremely impressive. Radar indicated hail up to the size of baseballs in Columbia County, New York. We got a report of baseball-sized hail in Columbia County, New York, extremely rare. By 3:25 p.m., elementary school buses in Region 1 were on hold until the warning would expire. By that time, the storm had entered Connecticut, but had weakened some, but was still a very strong storm, producing an EF1 tornado in the town of Salisbury, an unrated waterspout over the Barkhamsted Reservoir. The storm continued as it headed toward Norfolk, Heartland, and Granby. The storm produced another tornado near Norfolk. Hail sizes by this time were approaching tennis ball size, up to 2.5 inches, and that indeed fell in Heartland and Granby, and this was enough to total cars and break windows on houses. This was the first hailstorm in nearly 2 decades that was able to do damage to vehicles and homes. The storm finally fell apart after hitting Bradley International Airport, where the control tower had to be evacuated due to the storm, and a 44-knot wind gust was measured just before the storm rapidly weakened over the Connecticut River Valley. At this time, a new impressive and extremely frightening storm's signature was approaching northern Fairfield County. This is a very scary storm and a very dangerous, life-threatening storm. Doppler radar was estimating winds above the ground over 115 miles per hour. That was about 3,000 to 5,000 feet aloft, but they had no trouble mixing down with the extremely unstable atmosphere. The storm went on to produce a macro burst with winds over 100 miles an hour in New Fairfield, Brookfield, and Newtown. As the storm moved east into New Haven County, it produced an EF1 tornado over Southbury-Oxford line, and another tornado touched down near Hamden. Areas hit very hard by these tornadoes were Southbury, Oxford, Beacon Falls, Bethany, Hamden, and Wallingford. For the one of the only second times in New England TV markets and in Connecticut TV markets in Connecticut history, we were able to see lofted tornado debris outlined by a TDS. This is lofted tornado debris. It could either be anything from homes, pieces of homes, twigs, leaves, anything like that, sucked into the storm's updraft. What a truly remarkable storm this was. And as the storms moved over the Connecticut River Valley, they rapidly weakened, and the outbreak was finally coming to an end. The next day, we learned that 2 people had lost their lives when trees fell on their cars. Over 130,000 Eversource customers were left in the dark, and the cleanup was just beginning. Eversource stated that the May 15th tornado outbreak was more damaging than Hurricane Sandy back in 2012. They stated that during Sandy, 1,700 utility poles were broken, while on May 15th, there were 1,800. Another truly remarkable fact was during Hurricane Sandy, 105 miles of power lines were downed, while on May 15th, there were 288 miles of downed power lines. While making this video 2 years later, there are still downed trees in Half and Bethany. Forests that were once green, lush, and thick are now nothing but snapped dead trees and vegetation. Looks like a war zone almost 2 years later. All the tornadoes that touched down on May 15th were rated EF1 tornado, the strongest being in Hamden with winds up to 110 miles an hour, 1 mile per hour shy of an EF2 tornado. This storm destroyed a barn and also completely destroyed Sleeping Giant State Park. This was the largest severe weather outbreak that Connecticut has experienced in nearly two decades. 2 years later, people are still recovering, rebuilding their homes after the outbreak. In Newtown, 12 homes had to be condemned. 2 years later, Sleeping Giant is finally reopened, but still, there are scars everywhere. An estimated 2,000 trees fell in Sleeping Giant State Park alone. These storms that hit Connecticut on the afternoon were certainly the real deal and proved that Connecticut does get significant severe weather outbreaks. The morning of May 15th, 2018 started as any mid-spring day would. Temperatures were in the 50s and 60s with showers around. The Storm Prediction Center had a lot of Connecticut under an enhanced risk of severe weather, with your standard 5% tornado risk and a 30% hatch risk for significant wind damage and a small, slight hail threat. This was then upgraded to a moderate risk by the afternoon of the 15th, and by the mid-afternoon, we were in the middle of a very significant severe weather and tornado outbreak across the state of Connecticut. Storms came in fast and with power. By 2:58, a tornado warning was issued for the first storm of the day in far northwestern Connecticut. Storm produced two tornadoes in northern Connecticut, as well as extremely large hail to the size of tennis balls in Heartland and Granby. And that hail was enough to damage homes and vehicles. It was the first hailstorm in over two decades that was able to do so. The storm dropped two EF1 tornadoes and an unrated waterspout over the Bark Hampstead Reservoir. After those storms died out, significant storm was approaching northern Fairfield County, the towns of New Fairfield, Danbury, with a wind signature we have not seen on radar in quite some time. You have to go back years and years, maybe even decades, to see a radar signature like this, with winds radar indicating of 115 to 120 miles per hour, 3,000 to 5,000 feet aloft, and that had no trouble mixing it down to the surface, unfortunately. Trees came down on houses, vehicles, businesses. Trees came down everywhere in parts of Fairfield, New Haven, and Middlesex counties. This is like the second time in Connecticut history we were able to see a TDS, a tornado debris signature, on radar in Oxford from the tornado that was just south of Oxford, the Southbury-Oxford line. Produced an EF1 tornado there, and also produced another EF1 tornado near Hamden. That tornado in Hamden was the strongest of the day, with winds of 110 miles per hour, 1 mile per hour shy of an EF2 tornado. That was able to destroy a barn and destroyed Sleeping Giant State Park. Now, Sleeping Giant State Park is open to visitors, except not this year because of the whole virus, but it is open now, clean. There's still scars everywhere from that day, and we will not soon forget what happened that afternoon in May. thank you so much for watching. As you can see, this was a very crazy day. It's really what sparked my interest in weather and why I've been going so hard and learning about weather so much. It's a very crazy day in Connecticut, and let's hope nothing like this happens in the near future.